see the lights, it's the light, we're together now. I'm better, so much better now. Look to the skies, give me life, we're together now. We've only just begun, hypnotized by drums. Until forever comes, you'll find us chasing the sun. They said this day wouldn't come, and we refuse to run. We've only just begun, you'll find us chasing.
So, hey guys, so today's video is going to be on hamster traveling, or traveling with hamsters, and like the different types of traveling cages and carriers you can use, and some just information in general. So yeah, let's get started.
Okay, so I'm just going to start off with showing you a few different types of traveling cages, or things you might want to use, and some bad ones that you don't want to use. So I'm going to start off with the good ones. So I'm just going to start off with bringing your hamster home from like the shelter or the pet store, or just going somewhere that's like 10 minutes, not even, or something. Just like kind of coming home from like a pet store or something, or yeah, just bringing your hamster home for the first time and you need something to travel in. So this is just a really, really small Living World box. This is what, this is like a local pet store box, but they just use the Living World ones. Most likely a pet store will give you a box to bring your hamster home in, and it's mainly just a really thin box that you would just only bring your hamster home in from like a pet store or something. This would only work for like maybe 5 to 10 minutes, because it is very, very small. It's like the size of my hand. That's how big my hand is, kind of. It just is that small, so it's only like the size of your hand. And a Syrian will probably take up, like a baby Syrian, probably take up half of this. So I do not recommend putting your hamster in that unless your like pet store brings you something. But you can bring your own carriers, but some pet stores don't allow it. I'm not sure why, but yeah. So it would only work for 5 to 10 minutes, and even then I wouldn't really recommend it, because it is very, very thin, and it's a very, very easy to break out of. I've only used this when I got Lily, and she didn't chew out of here because I had another carrier, but this is just what she was hiding in. So I don't really recommend using that. And the next carrier I want to be talking about is another cardboard carrier. It's pretty hard to close. So this carrier is similar to one that you would get at like PetSmart or something. It is very, very big. Well, actually it's pretty big. This is a Pet Valley box, as you can see right there. And this is what I usually bring my hamsters home in, because it is very spacious, sorry, can't talk today. It's good for bringing your hamster home in, and if you're going to a pet store that's a little bit farther away, this would be good for maybe 15 to 20 minutes. And they can still chew out of this box, so I would bring an extra one just in case. And they usually give you a box anyway, so you could just bring an extra box or a different travel carrier, and that would be good. And so this is about two of my hands spread out, like this. So it is very big. So this is pretty big, and I would only recommend this for like 15 to 20 minutes or 25 minutes if your pet store is quite far away. You can also ask like a pet store for a cardboard box. I know my pet stores are really nice, and they'll be like, oh, okay, you can have one. And my Pet Valley uses this for a guinea pig and birds and stuff. I wouldn't recommend this for a guinea pig, because like the guinea pig would fit in there, and it would barely be able to turn around. I guess it could turn around, but you know. So I would recommend this box for bringing your hamster home the best, because it's pretty big, and it's a lot bigger than this, as you can see. It's taller, the hamster can stand up in it. This is about two of these boxes, I think. About two of them wide, a little bit more. And then a little bit more, like half an inch more that wide. And then it's a lot taller, it's a lot taller. So that would be like, these are two things you could use to bring your hamster home in. Like I said, a pet store will most likely give you a travel cage or a travel box that's cardboard. They can chew through it, but if you're not going to be like really long, I doubt your hamster will chew through it. But if you have a really scared hamster, I know Twilight chewed out of two boxes when I brought her home. And we had to basically go back and get a thicker box, and she chewed a hole in that one, but I was just making do until we got home. So, yeah, let's get on with bigger, kind of longer trips. Okay, so now pretty long trips, like a long, long car ride, and this can go from 30 minutes up. I wouldn't really recommend your hamster being in a travel cage traveling, like, straight without stopping for I wouldn't really recommend you'd have your hamster in traveling for more than 3 hours in a car, because that's really long and it's pretty stressful for them, and I don't really recommend it. Because if I was a hamster, I would want to be at my home and just, like, settle into their home as soon as possible. Okay, so the next thing you can use is a critter trail cage. I just have the critter trail 1 here, and this would be for 30 minutes and up to, like, I wouldn't recommend traveling with your hamster for more than 3 hours in the car, because it's really, really stressful, and they just want to get into their new home, so I really don't recommend that. In this cage, you can put bedding in it. It comes apart. They can sleep up here. Sorry, this is broken, but it still works. They can't escape, because Cheese lived in here for a while. And, yeah. This can come out, can put nesting material in there, and the whole thing comes out, and it comes with a wheel, a water bottle. Well, I actually have water still in here. And then I just have a little mini food dish that used to be Cheese's in there, because he passed away, but, yeah, I'm not going to get into that. And then there's, like, little tabs and stuff. This is broken over here, if you can see that. But, yeah, I would recommend this for a long journey, and this is a perfect-size travel cage. I do not recommend this for, like, a real hamster living in a cage, because it's, too small. But this is a good-sized travel cage, and it's pretty spacious for, spacious. I can't talk today. Ignore the background noise, Sugar's been playing. And, so yeah, it's really spacious, and it's good for a travel cage. So, let's just get on with bad travel cages. So the first one I'm going to be talking about is this box again. This box is not suitable for long car trips, or long journeys, I would say car trip, because you wouldn't really want to walk anywhere with your hamster, but, I would not recommend this longer than 15 minutes at the very maximum, because it is just too small, and they can easily chew out of it. And this bug container, this is way, way too small for a hamster, a mouse, even a bug to live in or travel in. The only thing you would want to put in there is probably a very small bug, because it is just way too small. I do have bedding in here because this, I use it as a burrow box sometimes. I put it in their cage, but I take the lid off and everything. There's bedding in there right now, but anyway, do not recommend this for any type of traveling cage. It is just way too small. It is, like, that big. It's like my hand, not even my hand, like, skinny. My hand, like, being like this. Not even the palm of my hand. It's just way, way, way too small. And it actually has barely any airflow, too. And the last thing I'm going to be talking about is any type of small little things they make in pet stores and stuff nowadays for hamsters that are advertised for hamsters. And, like, it's like a travel thing. I don't really know what this is for, but I got this for my... my mom, I think, got it. I got it in a pack of a bunch of critter trail tubes when I used to have those cages. I used to have, like, a whole bunch of them and connected together. And basically, just it comes with a tiny little water bottle, like this big. And it just has, like, a little, what is that called? It's a steering wheel. And it's supposed to be a food dish. And then there's the exit. And then the other one. That is way, way, way too small. And I do not recommend it. I would only use it to maybe put in their cage. But really, it's just a waste of money. And it's not good. So now I'm just going to get on with, how long you would want to keep them in the travel cage for how much period of time, and some good traveling options and some bad ones. So this, I would recommend only bringing your hamster home from the pet store or, like, wherever you get it from. Only bringing it there, like, bringing it home, and it would only be good for, like, 5 to 10 minutes, 15 minutes at the very maximum. This box is good for bringing your hamster home. Like, it's the best one you could use for bringing your hamster home. 15 to 20 minutes, maybe 25 minutes. It can still chew out of it, but it's way better than this. And you can use this for a little bit longer. And it is good for bringing your hamster home from, wherever you get them from, when you adopt them. And even if you had to transport them to maybe your babysitter if you're going on vacation. So, yeah. And this critter trail cage for... 30 minutes and up if you're going on a car ride, like a really long trip or something. Say you're going to visit your friends or something, and you're taking a car trip there, and it's like less than 2-3 hours, and it's not very long, so yeah. And it's very spacious. You can clean it, you can put bedding in it, you can put food, water, and that's probably 3.5 hours, I would think, is the very, very maximum to keep them in here for a car trip. And with this cage here, I'm just going to be talking about some good things, how you can travel, and some bad things. So good ways are in the car. It's probably, like, the only good way. And say if you had to take the bus to go get your hamster, I guess that's okay, but as long as it's not winter out with snow and then you're, like, standing at a bus stop or something, I'd really recommend just getting, like, if you don't have a, if your parents don't own a car, like get a taxi home with your hamster and something like that. But also just car rides, and that goes for all of them. Car rides, I do not recommend plane rides because they are very, very, very stressful and can possibly kill your hamster.
So I think that wraps up our video, my video. So if you have any further questions, just ask below or send me a PM. I really like reading your guys' comments and questions and everything. So feel free to comment, like, and if you would like me to do how to set up a hamster carrier when you're bringing them on bringing them somewhere, like for travel, just like this video or tell me below. And thanks for watching, guys. Bye.